Hey, you're out there. Welcome to the show. For the next 60 minutes, you'll be experiencing a new dimension in time and space. Acoustic television. Hit it, guys. It takes a lot of eucalyptus to feed a hungry bear. Lots of electricity to run the whole world's fair. You need a funky Bonnie for a continent Clyde chick. A woman like you to keep me satisfied. I saw you, baby, in the middle of last night. Couldn't sleep a wink till the early morning light. I'm gonna find you, mama, you got no place to hide. Chicks, a woman like you to keep me satisfied. I've been looking for someone like you for my whole life, don't you know? When I found you, gonna put my arms around you, and I ain't gonna let you go. It takes some rocks and gravel to make a solid road. A mighty big diesel to tow a heavy load. And a man needs a woman walking by his side. Takes a woman like you to keep me satisfied. Electricity there on the whole world's fair. I've been around this wide world, so many things I tried. Takes a woman like you to keep me satisfied. Yeah, I've been around this wide world, so many things I tried. Takes a woman like you to keep me satisfied. It takes a woman like you to keep me satisfied. Thank you. Thank you. Well, we have a marvelous show for you tonight. My guests include the wonderful songwriter Darius, incomparable Lowen Navarro, and the magnificent Victoria Williams. So stick around, stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
This company needs quick decisions. So does yours. This company needs leaders. So does yours. This company needs well-trained people. So does yours. So when this company needs to borrow people from your company,
come on, man, move it on. Let's go, let's go.
Remember, they'll always come back better than they were before.
Hey, Bill, could we get your approval on this?
Be a hero. Give your employees the freedom to protect ours.
You, John Fitzgerald Kennedy, do solemnly swear.
I, John Fitzgerald Kennedy, do solemnly swear.
That you will faithfully execute
And I will faithfully execute the office
of President of the United States.
Of President of the United States.
And will, to the best of my ability,
preserve, protect, and defend
the Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
The Constitution, the words we live by.
The stiletto, outlawed in most major cities. The trench knife, it boasts a 7-inch solid steel blade. The survival knife, designed to cut through virtually anything. Yet the most dangerous knife of all may be the one we use to eat too much high-fat food, the ordinary table knife. For a free booklet on how to help reduce your risk of cancer and heart disease through low-fat eating, call 1-800-EAT-LEAN.
I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed days, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
If you're not recycling, you're throwing it all away.
Well, are we back now? We are back, and welcome back to the show. I hope everybody out there had a great week, because we did over here. We were riding high from a super show last week, and we had Floyd Dixon was supposed to get here. We found out what happened to him, and he, poor man, was given the wrong directions and was waiting for 2 hours. So we hope that we're going to get him back, because we need him, but we have plenty of great acts for you tonight. What's happening this week is we've got another Supercharged week coming up. Lawrence Lebo is having a party at the Musician's Record Shop here. Can you get a shot of this on Sunday? And she's going to be on the show October 9th, I believe it is if that's a Monday, around that time. We'll tell you about it. From 2 to 6 p.m. at the Musician's Record Shop at 1624 Lincoln Boulevard. It's going to be a fun party, and she's going to be playing with her little big band. And her new album is called Don't Call Her Larry. On Thursday, Smokey is going to be at the Breakaway, the old club on Venice Boulevard and Inglewood. And I hope you can come down at 10 o'clock. Brad Bailey is going to be there at 9 from Flying Colors. And we're going to play a set of 10 with some friends. It's going to be a great night, so please come on down. It's this Thursday, the 21st of September. Right now, I want to introduce my first guest, who's a wonderful singer-songwriter. Just had a record released on Gold Castle Records, and I was fortunate enough to go to the record release party, which was pretty wild, at the Breakaway last Friday, and we'll talk about that a little bit more. What they say about Darius's music is sprawling ballads on the human condition, irreverent musical poems about politics and religion, lusty tales of travel, drink, and romance. This is Darius. Let's have a warm welcome for Darius.
A human life, get me out of bed. That and other guilty feelings running through my head. Someday I'll be free enough to sleep my life away and laugh at everybody else working. Ha ha! Well, everybody talks as if they really know a lot. Luckily, I understand the problem they've got. I've been known to tell a tale once or twice before, but don't you worry, this isn't one of those. No, 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 no. Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, 6 or 7 weeks ago, I found myself in Watts. I was playing in the park, some would call it a parking lot. A couple of pretty black women walked up to me and said, "Ooh, there's a white boy raving." I took it as a compliment, played another song. I tried to make it funnier and not so very long, but that compliment's been truly inspirational to me. I think of myself as a white boy raving. Yeah, yeah, yeah. When I think of every president's imperialistic bid, I wonder how America's hoodwinked by those squid. Ooh, the CIA will be after me for that. But I'm just a white boy raving. I consider all the people who so earnestly voted. My suggestion is those guys be demoted. Send them off as astronauts or get them into Zen. But put them away so we can never vote for them again. Now I feel guilty having mentioned politics. I hate to waste my breath even talking about those dicks. It's the greatest show on earth, I admit it's true. But I still prefer this circus or a Sunday at the zoo. A Sunday at the zoo.
Darius, I was going to talk to you about the songs and the album, but I think what's more important, let's talk about your hat. Where'd that hat come from?
This is a special hat that I found, like most of my clothing, because I only wear clothes that I found. I think that's a good tenet to go through life by. Or that people give you.
Where'd you find it?
Never buy any clothes.
Where'd you find it?
This was left at this house, and it's a Workers of the World Unite hat, I think.
Yeah, listen, let's get serious now for about a second.
Come on.
In your songs, you seem to be like an observer going through the world. I know you write songs about exotic places, Turkey and the United States and Los Angeles. What gets you going to write like that? I mean, that's kind of a typical stupid question, but I want you to answer it in a typical smart way.
Well, that's a tough one, man. You know, just keeping my eyes open and writing about what I see. I mean, I think that's what most writers do.
Uh-huh. Is that how you got to the song about the park?
Dorothy J. Benjamin B. Smith Park.
Yeah, what's the story about that? That's on the Breakaway record, isn't it?
Right,
yeah.
Right. That's a park up there in Hollywood on Franklin Avenue at Sycamore. And it's just a great, it's a fantastic park because it's very small. I mean, like a lot. Yet there's this huge sign, it has this huge name, Dorothy J. Benjamin B. Smith Park. And I was always, interested in the disparity between the size of the park and the length of the name.
That's what comes across in the song. Anyway, I know that you can't stay for the jam because you're working at the Breakaway tonight doing the open mic. Darius is there every Monday doing the open mic and doing a fine job of it. But right now, will you sing us another song?
Certainly will.
What's it called?
It's called The Chosen Ones, and we should also introduce Don Teschner over here, who's going to play some mandolin.
Let's introduce Don Teschner and Darius.
Thank you, Smokey.
Got a prayer. The fairy tale inspection team is painfully aware that on highway, sea, and railroad track or through the dirty air, behind ramparts built of people's fears, they hide the truth with care. method to be free. And the blindest bat can see all the water is holy. All the people are the chosen ones. Water walkers, garbage men, and astronauts above can perceive the remnants of a vast, deluded love. Cobra charmers, TV stars, mendacious millionaires. Auto workers clearly see all the water is holy. All the people are the chosen ones. In a greasy urban restaurant, I saw an old man cry. Silver tears on charcoal cheeks, I had to ask him why. Weary featured waitress filled his cup with more coffee, turned his head and spoke to me. All the water is holy. All the people are the chosen ones. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's Darius. Darius is great. Thanks, Darius, for being here with us. We'll see you. We'll see you later, man. Right now, I want to tell you, we love hearing from you. I mean, we really, really do love hearing from you. So we're going to show you the address that you can write to us here at the Smokey Miles Music Hour. Grab your pencils, pens, paper, charcoal, whatever, and take down this address and send us your thoughts, and we'll read the best ones on the air.
I'm all right the way I am. I still believe in perfect love. I still believe in true romance. Living that live is what this world ought to be made of. I take my stand. I'm a natural man. I'm a natural man in an artificial world. It's plastic, fantastic, and spins you around. A natural man in an artificial world. I'm just trying to keep my feet on the ground. Just trying to keep my feet on the ground. I'm fed up with hypocrites and liars.
Hi, we're back here with you. My next guest is a wonderful singer, songwriter, and a dear, dear person. She has recorded an album on Geffen Records, about to do her next album. Gal from Louisiana, let's have a warm welcome for Victoria Williams.
I was on my way to Continental. I had plenty to do when I got there. Then there was a big traffic jam. I looked around and said, everybody's late as I am. And then I thought, why not think it again? Maybe we're all on time, my friend. On time, on time, always on time. Why, you might be a fidgeting, standing in a line, but don't fret, don't worry, just feel peace of mind, peace of mind that you're always on time. There once was a man with a clock on his hand. Sour note in his heart, a tight grip on his plan. One day he awoke to hard times and spoke, how long have I been blind to the fact that you're always on time? On time, on time, always on time. Why, you might be crazy, about to lose your mind. Well, don't fret, don't worry, just feel peace of mind. Peace of mind that you're always on time. They say no one will know the day or the hour. Always on time. Well, on time, on time, always on time. Why, you might be going crazy, about to lose your mind. But don't fret, don't worry, just a feel peace of mind. That peace of mind that you're always on time. I said, don't fret, don't worry. Always on time. Thank you. Thank you, Doug.
Too. Victoria. Victoria, come on over. Come on over here. Now that you sang that song, now I've got something to talk to you about. What happened? You almost didn't make it here tonight. And I know you came just at the last minute, and I know that y'all always on time. What happened?
Well, we made it, so then I guess we were on time.
That's good.
So here we are. Like, there were some traffic jams, and there was some driving down the wrong roads to get to this here.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Directions weren't good, huh?
Yeah.
Well, listen, if you're...
But I don't know that they weren't good. I mean, could have been the other way, but it's not the right way to go.
If you're in Louisiana, how's the traffic down in Louisiana?
In Louisiana?
Yeah. I want to know because traffic is getting pretty heavy here.
Well, Louisiana's in the depression, and there's not very much traffic in Louisiana. It's pretty slow.
It's pretty slow?
I mean, the only traffic in Louisiana is from out here, people going to buy all the land up.
Where are you from in Louisiana?
Shreveport.
Shreveport? And that's where you started picking the guitar and writing songs?
Uh-huh.
Is that in the bayou country?
Yeah, there's bayous there.
Did you ever see any alligators?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
What's it like when you're driving? And I've always been curious about this. When you're driving down the road and all of a sudden you see an alligator coming at you?
Well, I never saw alligator in the road. I saw armadillos in the road. But one time there was an alligator in our pond, and we put chicken necks all out on the bank. And then, well, it's because it got the dog that we shot the alligator. But see, that was the year that the alligators had gotten, it was legal to shoot them because they had overpopulated because it was in a farm pond.
Uh-huh.
Because alligators aren't usually in a farm pond. They have to go through the lake, up the bayou, then up a creek to get to a pond. And so that means they're real hungry to get there.
So these alligators, so every once in a while the alligators get hungry and then everyone's...
Well, when they're overpopulated, see, they said you couldn't kill them for a while. And then they alligators have a lot of babies when and so they get overpopulated very quickly.
Well, I'm glad you're telling me about this. And we could, well, let's continue about this later because I've always been fascinated by alligators. In fact, I have a book about alligators and I'll show you this book. It might interest you. But right now we've got, I've got a clip of Pine Top Perkins singing at the Southern California Blues Festival around 1988. So let's take a look and then we'll have more from Victoria Williams. Victoria Williams is now going to sing for us a song called Summer of Drugs.
70s in the summer of the drugs. Mamas and daddies could never understand that life was never dull. Their idea of a rollicking time was a kitchen taffy pull. Suspect those kids were monsters neath their makeup. Whoa, they was too young to be a hippie. Missed out on the love. Turned to a teen in the late 70s in the summer of the drugs. Boys and girls in every town. Sandman spread.
Victoria Williams. Victoria. We'll be right back.
People all said, because of the chemicals, our babies are dead. Don't rape my world. Don't rape your world. Don't rape the world.
Hello, you've tuned right back into the Smokey Miles Music Hour live here every Monday night, and we hope that you come back next Monday and tune in. Anyway, right now it's time for Smokey to tell you a story. This is Smokey's Corner. I've got a story to tell you about how we started. A friend of mine asked me how we got started doing the show, and I figured, well, I'd tell you tonight. It all started with a friend of mine named, believe it or not, Mr. Hydro. This is Mr. Hydro. Mr. Hydro was sleeping one day, and he woke up early in the morning. He bolted up. Mr. Hydro bolted up and said, I'm going to look for the secret of life. But he talked like this. I'm going to look for the secret of life. So Mr. Hydro put on his elegant black hat, just like Smokey's, and took a walk down the road, down the road. Can you see Mr. Hydro? Yes, Mr. Hydro walked down the road until he came to the purple palm tree. And underneath the purple palm tree was, we see that here, was his friend Mr. Goop. And Mr. Goop got up and he says, hi, Mr. Hydro. Hi, Mr. Hydro. How are you doing today? Mr. Hydro said, well, fine, Mr. Goop. How would you like to go for a walk? Oop, there goes his elegant black hat. Okay, and Mr. Goop, who's, you know, kind of getting into it, he says, sure, I'd like to go for a walk. What for, Mr. Hydro? And he says, well, I'm looking for the secret of life. Oop, there goes that hat again. He says, I'm looking for the secret of life. So Mr. Goop says, well, I know there's a magic crystal in the Emerald Forest. Let's go take a look. So they took a walk down into the Emerald Forest, and while they were walking, they're walking, walking, walking for hours and hours, and who did they come to? But Mr. Turtle. Oh, hi, guys, said Mr. Turtle. Hi, Mr. Turtle, said the Goop. And hi, Mr. Turtle, said Mr. Hydro. What are you doing here, Mr. Goop and Mr. Hydro, said Mr. Turtle. Well, we're looking for the secret of life in the Emerald Forest. And Mr. Turtle said, no, it's too dangerous. So Mr. Goop just got on Mr. Turtle's back and said, forget it. He gooped him. And they kept walking. And then they came to the horrible monster who says, it's too dangerous back in the forest. So Mr. Goop jumped on the monster. He gooped him. And he kind of knocked him out of the picture for a while. Then he came to this horrible monster creature who said something like this. And Mr. Goop said, ah, get out of here. And he got rid of him. Finally, they came to the magic crystal, and Mr. Smokey's magic hand lifted up the dome and the magic crystal. The magic crystal came up. They said, we're looking for the secret of life. And the magic crystal said, well, the secret of life is a fine wine, a good woman, and a 66 Martin D28 guitar. And that's how the show was born. And Mr. Hydro was so excited, he squirted.
At you and you're never the same. I can't understand this aching and pain down in my heart that you're making me feel, turning me around like a spinning wheel, like a tire of a walker walking the wire. Hey, I'm a mystifier. Hey, I'm a mystifier. Something to me that don't feel bad. You do something to me that's driving me mad. My train's unsteady, my emotions all shook. My concentration shot, I can hardly read a book. You chill me and you thrill me and you fill me with desire. Hey, I'm a mystifier. Hey, I'm a mystifier. Lighting my fire, inflaming my imagination with desire. I'm running to you now, it's love you inspire. Who mystifier? Who mystifier? I see you when I'm sleeping, hear the sound of your voice. If the must be a slavery, I got no choice. My feelings swell like a bellowing sea, but you don't even know what you're doing to me. You're selling me a treasure chest and I'm your buyer, and you're my mystifier.
Hello, we're back and we're live, and this is Monday night. We're at the Smokey Miles Music Hour. I'd like to introduce my next guests. They're some very good friends of mine and wonderful musicians. They wrote We Belong for Pat Benatar and a couple songs on the new Bangles album. Let's have a warm welcome for Lowen and Navarro.
Don't waste your breath, don't waste my time. If I hear one more excuse, I'll lose my mind. It's been a quiet war behind closed doors. Ain't it getting hard to keep your balance anymore? Walking on a wire, higher and higher. You told the truth, but you're still a liar, walking on a wire. You deal in black and white, and everything in between. You were blessed with such finesse, I almost know what you mean. Or I could close my eyes, pretend to let it pass. But you live on borrowed time and it would never last. Walking on a wire, higher and higher. You told the truth, but you're still a liar. Walking on a wire, walking on a wire. Gonna fall. Was it safer with your back up against the wall? And why did you try when you knew you were losing? Just one mistake and you're losing it all. If I hear one more excuse, I'll lose my mind. Walking on a wire, higher and higher. You told the truth, but you're still a liar. Walking on a wire, walking on a wire. So high. I'm finding a way to tell the truth this time. So lost and alone, I did not know. Then you let the lions go, and the lights come on, and the fire burns, but only in your eyes. The force that came like a hurricane and blew my wasted life away. Oh, Mary, oh, Mary, you remember the man I used to be, so reckless and wild and much too full of me. So
Navarro. We'll be right back to talk to these soulful sons of melody, but first, check this out.
You say it's all over. I say we're just starting to start. The sky is filled with a thousand stars that can tear your soul apart. I can't quit you now. It's something my pride won't allow. It can't stop the dreams of someone who has thunder in his heart. Thunder's in my heart tonight, raging like a storm on a mountainside. Let me hold you in my arms so tight, like I never let you go. Thunder's in my heart tonight, and the moon is shining bright. Baby, hold me close and tight. Don't ever let me go. Thunder's in my heart tonight, raging like a storm on a mountainside. Let me hold you close and tight, and I'll never let you go.
That's it. So we hope to see you on Thursday night, 10 o'clock. Smokey will be playing at the Breakaway on Venice Boulevard in Inglewood. And 9 o'clock will be Brad Bailey from Flying Colors. So we hope that you come down and tell them Smokey sent you. We're going to see you there. Right now, I'm here with the gentleman that just sang for you, Lowen and Navarro. It's Eric Lowen. Can we get him? And Dan Navarro. And these fellas have been around the Los Angeles area for a while, and also in New York.
For a while,
and many places. they wrote the song We Belong for Pat Benatar, and they have got a couple of songs on the Bangles album.
They're playing around, so you can watch for them unless there's some gig that you want to plug right now.
We're playing Friday night at Cafe Largo on 432 North Fairfax in Hollywood, California.
September 30th?
September 29th.
September 29th at the Breakaway, and then October 3rd at the Club Lingerie.
Okay, check the calendars for them, write it down, but check it out in the LA Weekly.
Sure.
All right, now how did you guys get together?
With great difficulty. We met, took one look at each other, and realized that if we didn't become friends, we were going to kill one another.
And we didn't really get along.
At all.
Is that right?
At all. We hated each other when we first met. We sang together and we realized we sang real good together. Haven't learned to like each other any better, but...
Because you guys are known around town as kind of a magical combination.
Well, that's what we couldn't fight, but we're like everything else we can fight about.
Right? We're like epoxy, you know? I mean, you know, one's the catalyst and the other's the hardener or whatever the hell it is.
Yeah, something like that.
All right, now we got into epoxy. Let's do some free association.
Stuck to you like glue. Let me think.
Birds.
Oh, we're going to write a song. Oh, good. I love it.
Yeah, let's write a song right
now. This is how you write commercial songs, don't you see? You sit around there and you go, well, I don't know, okay, maybe it's, we can talk about birds and we can use a glue reference. Okay, stuck to you like bird feathers. Hey, I just broke something.
Okay.
Mazel tov.
Mazel tov. We're writing a song
and
now.
I'm not even Jewish.
Maybe you can help us out. Send us your lines right here, and we'll see if we can put them in the song called, what are we going to call it?
Stuck to You Like Bird Feathers.
Stuck to You Like Bird Feathers.
Yeah. The next hit from Lowen Navarro.
Yeah, thank you.
Stuck to You Like Bird Feathers. How about another one? Aardvark.
Same to you.
Yes, on Blueberry Ant Hill. I don't know.
Blueberry
Ant Hill. There we go.
This is how songs get written. Actually, they do.
They do.
Absolutely.
Good ones.
Songs do get written. How do you guys write songs?
We sit around and we just throw ideas back and forth, and best idea wins.
That's how we're doing it. So we're doing it right now.
Yeah. That's right.
We'll be back with Lowen Navarro and the rest of the insane gang who's been here with us tonight with a jam. So stay tuned. So there we were.
Lucky one in a whirlwind of zone.
Thank you for watching us tonight. We're real happy that you tuned in. We're live, and we'll be live next week with my guests Len Chandler and John Brahaney and Carolyn Hester and J. Allen Friedman. I want to thank my guests who have been here tonight, Darius, Victoria Williams, Lowen Navarro, and all the other musicians who accompany them. Their names will be on the credits. Right now, we're going to jam for you. So thanks again, and stay happy, healthy, and be natural. A song called Long Black Veil goes like this.